What do you get when you combine farming with craft brewing? You get Hof ten Dormaal here in Tildonk, Belgium.
I'm Jeff. I just retired from the military, sold everything I own, and now I'm traveling around the world to learn from brewers, winemakers, distillers, and tell their story. This is my journey of beer, wine, and spirits.
Hey guys, I'm Jeff. I'm a brewer at Hof ten Dormaal. Cheers.
Cheers.
My parents bought a farm,
refurbished it,
came to live in it, and my brother always wanted to be a farmer. Like it's, I wanted to be a professional football player, but yeah, for obvious reasons I failed. But he always wanted to be a farmer from when he was a kid. And we bought a farm. We had like a couple of hectares and we needed a way for make the farm viable. Cheese or maybe ice cream. And then my father, at the same time, he was an accountant and he was really getting depressed of that job. And he went to the States for a search himself again. Okay. 2 weeks and he came back, I bought a brewery. No experience at all. My brother and I drank on the normal stuff, like pilsners basically. My father didn't drink at all. So we bought a brewery, installed the brewery, and started brewing. With help from a guy who knew brewing, of course. And then after that, yeah, we just turned out, it, like the brewing aspect of it, it's not that hard.
Whose idea was it to say, you know what, when we got a farm, let's plant hops?
Yeah, basically, that was the whole idea from when we started the brewery, to make it as self-sustainable as we could. Because it's impossible to do it 100% self-sustainable, because we don't have a maltery. It's a different profession, it's precise work, so we chose not to malt. So, and then, yeah, hops was the next logical step. So we have the grains, then, yeah, you need hops too, and why not plant hops?
Obviously, America's saturated, the craft brewery scene, very saturated. Belgium right now is starting to pick up.
Yeah, Belgium always has been saturated.
Yeah,
such a small country.
Yeah.
Like Belgians pretend they're beer geeks, and we're Belgium, so we must know about beer. So you get born as a beer connoisseur in Belgium. Most of the breweries own bars in Belgium. They get to decide what's in the bar. And now there's an influx of small breweries. And there's so much these days. Not all amazingly good. A lot of them are, not all. The time for making adequate but not amazing beers is over. Just do single batch. You can do like a couple of them, of course.
What other things on the farm that you grow that you add?
So we have barley, spelt, wheat, rye, oats. Those are our grains. Then we have Magnum hops. This year in March-ish, we planted 7 new hops. Low trellis, all Roma hops, like Germans basically, because all the cool ones are trademarked.
How are the hops? They look like they're faring really well out there. They grow pretty...
You can plant hops anywhere. It'll grow. The yield is pretty good here, but it's probably... They're gonna burn. Not actually combust into flames. Like getting way too dry. Because there's a heat wave.
Yes.
Starting today.
Yeah. It is.
Always awesome to have a brewery in a heat wave.
And talk to me about the, so you got some new construction going on back there, greenhouse.
Yeah.
And you're looking to obviously grow hops.
Yeah, so we're starting up a small scale ID. We build a greenhouse. We're gonna try and plant hops to yield all year. Different plants that yield at different times. We can basically once spread the work of picking hops. We have a machine from the 60s, but it's still a hard working day. It's amazing. Being able to have like crisp, fresh hop anytime you want would be nice.